Hello, everybody. This is Lisa, Jews, Gentiles. This is a encouragement for the marriage, kingdom marriages video right now. Heavenly Father, we thank you, Jesus. Let us be encouraged, oh Lord, that the spouses and the wives be encouraged, Father, to stand in the gap, Father, to know that the things you say shall come to pass, Father, in the name of Jesus. The changes to sin and descend, block everything that tries to come through that's not of you, cast it into the pit of hell, cast it out seven ways, devour it in the name of Jesus. Father God, let the words of my mouth, meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. I thank you all for your subscribers, new comers, old comers, returning viewers. Thank you. And the things, the prayers, and everything that you all give. Yes, everybody. I was just laughing to myself because I was thinking that really women are strong. Okay. I don't understand why any man would think that a woman is not. Okay. Women are strong beings. They're strong beings, all right, strong creatures. And you gotta have the patience of Job with this kingdom marriage relationship stuff right now, because you have to remind yourself that the things that God had told you, okay. So if you somebody that you say, well, this is too hard for me, this waiting period, you know, the people aren't coming from their ways or whatever, you have to go back and pray about it and just ask God to give you the strength and stamina. Because God told you something, that these people ought to be with you, that this is something that was ordained before we was even born, okay? So we have to believe that God, what God says, all right? God is not gonna lie to us, you all. He isn't. And I know you want to give up. No one knows. I know you want to give up, but God is turning our Boazes around. They're gonna go through like a spiritual baptism. He's gonna clean them up, all right, and they're gonna come back running to you with open arms. And men, when you receive your roofs, and vice versa, when roofs receive your Boazes, I need you all to love each other tremendously with the love of the Lord. All right. The Lord gave me that there was a French kiss done from the adversary, from the counterfeit. Okay. From the counterfeit, there was a French kiss done, and it was, see, this is a game. See, you have your counterfeits calling your husbands clowns. Charlie Brown, he's a clown. They think their husband is a clown. Okay. This is a game to them. All right. They playing with God, and God is gonna fix your situation though, okay? Trust and believe, because God is in a divine, he has a divine plan, he has a divine time. But these are people that are really playing. They're playing games. It's a game to them. This is a game. It's jealousy, you know, the people that really, really don't want you to have, and they don't want you, but they don't want you to have it, and it's tricks. It's tricks. Cause you know, people do this. People will do this. It's a game to them. All right. Watch me do this. See what I do. All right. And then they, you know, and it's from lust, and it's from fantasy. And but God is fixing your Boaz's hearts. He's fixing your Boaz's hearts. That they're gonna just see you and see your value. All right. Just like Xerxes, King Xerxes, saw that Esther, out of all of those other women, all right, that the eunuchs was prepping. Xerxes, King Xerxes, saw the heart of Esther, all right. Boaz saw the heart of Ruth. Okay, so this is gonna happen. There was a kiss, and we know that Judas, it's like a Judas. Judas kissed God with a Judas kiss. He turned on God. So God gave me that, he was telling me, go speed racer, go. And it's mock, the word mock, MACH, when I looked that up, This was about adulterous woman, okay? This is the way of an adulterous woman. She wipes her mouth and says, "I have done nothing wrong." Wipe out, okay? It means wipe out. She say, "I have done nothing wrong." So this is like a betrayal kiss, all right? That came up. Like a betrayal kiss. And in Proverbs 30:20, it talks about this. Now, this was somebody that was trying to come up against your marriage, that try to do a Judas kiss, all right? So in Genesis 7:23, it says he wiped out every living thing. He erased it that was on the surface of the ground from mankind, the livestock, creatures that crawl to the birds of the sky. They wiped off the earth. Okay, so God is wiping this out. God is wiping this counterfeit off of your life. All right, he's going to implement the plans that he has. Your weddings will go on, okay? But we if you want, you know, it's like, wait, if God told you this person is good for you, this is the person for you, that you're going to go good together in the kingdom, then that's what it is, okay? I know it's frustrating, trust me. I know it's hard. You just want to give up and call and say forget it, you know, but you if you somebody that's God-fearing, you know that God won't lie to you, okay? So we have to keep praying for one another. Men pray for your wives. Wives pray for your men. You got to keep praying for one another and keep encouraging. All right. Whether you're around a person or not, you know, keep in prayer. So in Exodus 32:33, it says, "The Lord replied to Moses, 'I will erase whoever has sin against me from my book.'" All right. God is really erasing these things that's trying to hinder his marriages right now. He's coming down on them. They under judgment right now. They have to flee from you. He say, resist the devil, he must flee. Some of you mates, men and women, you don't understand what happened, what the enemy sent in a counterfeit person. All right, trying to use a counterfeit person against your marriage, okay? Because that's what they do. They hate marriage. So the song was in my mind suddenly. Your kingdom marriages are going to happen. The new revelation is coming to these marriages, and the song suddenly is there. Because you are really in their hearts. You really are. You're in their hearts. They love you, okay? They just being used by the enemy, but God is going to bring you around. Suddenly, I used to think love was just a fairy tale until the first hello, until that first smile. But if I had to do it all again, I wouldn't change a thing, because this love is everlasting. Hallelujah. Suddenly, life has new meaning to me. There's beauty up above and things we never take notice of. You wake up and suddenly you're in love. I used to love that song. Oh yeah, girl, you're everything a man could want and more. 1,000 words are not enough to say what I feel inside. Holding hands as we walk along the shore, never felt like this before. Now you're all I'm living for. Suddenly life has new meaning to me. There's beauty up above and things we never take notice of. Wake up and suddenly you're in love. This is how the spouses are feeling towards you. They know God is showing them who you are. He's showing them who the counterfeits are, that the counterfeits are playing games. The counterfeits are thinking that they're clowns, okay? They're not taking it serious. And that God is opening the eyes of your mates, all right? John 3:35, unless you are born again, you cannot see the kingdom of God, and unless you are born of water and of spirit, you cannot enter the kingdom of God. There need to be a major discomfort with the old position, the old self. See, God is putting away the old self from your mates, because you can't go into his assignments and kingdom with the old self lingering around. God is going to erase some things. See, you got to realize that God took Saul down the Damascus road, and Saul became a new person. All right, he had to blind him. put him on that Damascus Road. Ananias had to come and heal his eyes. So God is saying, go speed racer right now, go speed racer, go. This is a movement of God, that God has a time frame for his marriages to happen. Okay, so obedience is better than sacrifice. So when you receive these marriages, please treat one another as God wants you. You have to pray together, because it's family to pray together, stay together. All right, and God is wiping out these counterfeit people that's around you in your life, because if they're not in the plan, they have to go. By hook or crook, they have to go. They have to get on out of here. All right, the Vashtis are leaving the building for the Ruths. I mean, for the Esthers. God says, soon be over. Rise up and walk. Rise above the past. Commit to doing more for the kingdom of God. Obey Christ and walking into new life. Revelations 21:4. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes. Death shall be no more. Neither shall there be no mourning, no crying, no pain anymore, for the former things are passed away. Second Corinthians, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation, and the old has passed away. Behold, the new has come. See, God is purifying people, because I was seeing people going backwards and like a baptism. So God is purifying people. These your mates really have you on their minds and their hearts, and they have never experienced any love like this before. That God has put in their hearts for you. They have not, experienced anything like this. God has also given me the wedding march, everyone. Okay. So I want you to know that these weddings are still coming. These weddings are still on. I know it looks weird, it looks crazy, it looks strange, you tired, you worn out. Like I say, women are strong. God say, bone of my
This
bone,
prophetic encouragement was curated for November
flesh of my
23rd.
flesh. He say, I shall be called woman. What God has joined together, let no man put asunder. So when these relationships come, treat each other right. Love each other like God says to love. Put the best foot forward in these marriages. All this waiting and waiting and waiting, is for a reason. You go, God will provide the double for your troubles, everybody, okay? So it's going to soon be over. God is ushering in these marriages. You're going to be seeing these
This
marriages
prophetic
come about,
encouragement was
okay?
curated for November 23rd,
God is
2020.
ushering in these marriages, and I want you all to stay prayed up, all right? Talk to God. Be encouraged no matter what's going on. You are stronger than you think you are. All right. Father God, we thank you, Jesus. May you lift us up, keep us encouraged. Father, over our marriages and waiting periods and over marriages. Father God, we just thank you, Lord, to give us the strength and stamina. Stay strong. Let us treat each other well. Lord Jesus, in this, once we receive these marriages, Father, in the name of Jesus, the three people you connecting and reconnecting and reuniting. Father God, let us be obedient to you. In Jesus' name, amen. Stay encouraged. It's not easy, but we can do it because we have a heart for God. All right. There's work to do in this God's kingdom. Two shall become one. Three-strand cord is not easily broken. Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Father, Boaz and Ruth, okay? Hold on, everybody. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.